So, hello everyone. Sorry for the delay. I'll go to the slides a bit more quickly. Pointer, okay. So, this session is about taking our Angular application to the next level. Normally, it was the intention to talk a bit talk about Duotix, the company that I work for, but I will go that to that much more quickly. So, who am I? A beautiful picture of me. I am a front-end developer at Duotix, a company based in Zedelheim. I love making beautiful websites and beautiful web applications, and I have a very strong passion for Angular. So Duotix, this is the team. At one point, there are some people who are left and some people who are added to the team. So Duotix, basically, we do some whenever we start a project, we do an analysis of the project to make the communication better for the client. We do that by naming, design, story, and photography. And on the web department, we do that with websites, web shops, applications, and we also make, that's a very important point, that all the websites or every web shop or every web application is manageable and future-proof. If that is already done, then we go to the digital marketing and print and advertising. So that was very quickly. It was normally the intention that I talked a little bit more, but this video is completely in Dutch. So if there's anybody who doesn't understand Dutch, sorry for that. It doesn't have English subscriptions or subtitles. But it's basically everything that I needed to say in the slides before, shortly combined in a video of 3 minutes.
Om het Angular na te laten heb je niet meer nodig dan 1 seconde. Ons doel is om een sterk draagvlak te creëren voor jouw merk. Want jouw merk is niet alleen jouw merk, het is van iedereen. Iedere volger, liker, klikker, lezer, tweeter en swiper. Kortom, mensen. Voor er een concept bedacht is, een pixel ontworpen, een zin geschreven of code gedipt, nemen we de tijd om jou te leren kennen. Wij weten dat beelden meer zeggen dan 1000 woorden. Een huisstijl de basis is van je merk. Digitale marketing niet mag voelen als marketing en een website de identiteit weerspiegelt. Wij weten dat 1 seconde het verschil kan maken.
Oh my god, that was laggy. okay, so basically, in a quote, combines our creative team provides the perfect mix between web, brand, and strategic marketing. This ideal mix brings your company closer to your customer, ready for tomorrow and the day after. So that was everything about Duotix. So now I'm going to talk about Angular. That's why you're all here. I hope so. So it's my intention with this session to go to a few steps of how to make your Angular application much better. These steps are tools that exist already a year or 2 years, I don't know, but those are steps that mostly some developers lose out of touch or yeah, basically that. So first question, if I ever talk to someone who's doing React, I always love to talk about this discussion. What's the better framework, Angular, React, Vue? Basically, I don't have the answer for that. I believe that it's Angular, because Angular is a bigger package, it's a better deal. It's a whole completely combined, and the other frameworks are also doing that, but more focused on one part of the journey. Next point on the agenda of making the application better in Angular is keeping in touch with the update stream that Angular provides. So every 2 months, I think, or every 3 months, Angular makes a breaking change update. So 2 years ago, there was Angular 2. Now it's Angular 8. Normally it was Angular 9, but they're a little bit behind. As a developer, I think this is the most important part of whole the Angular experience, that you'll start with the latest version of Angular. I know that it's very difficult if you have a big project and there are breaking changes, if you have to update them. I know from experience they can be a pain in the ass. But if you do, your application will automatically be better, because Angular fixes so much stuff in their source code. So if you don't go with the flow, you're behind. Normally, it was the intention to talk about Angular 9, but it's not out yet. But the only thing I can say is that also a very big important update with the whole Ivy compiler system that's ready to launch. Next point, I'll talk about a little bit about our philosophy of making an application in Angular. So it's basically our setup of a project. I hope it's readable for everyone. Whenever we start an Angular CLI project, CLI Angular project, I mean, we start basically from an Angular CLI template, but it's a little bit tweaked with our own stuff to make it a little more maintainable. Because Angular CLI is a great tool for keeping in touch with also a lot of upgrades that Angular does. But if you'll keep changing with the CLI, I think it's a whole lot of brain ache that you don't need, I think. A little bit more about these two folders. We have a global folder. That's basically where everything, you can see the projects folder. So it's one project, one folder, or one application where multiple projects can be put in. So here you can see there's one project in. It's called Beheer, a management tool. You will see in the next slides a little bit more about this management tool. It's a headless CMS of ours that we completely made in Angular. In global, it's basically where you put all the global stuff, so components or services, everything that's needed for all the projects, you can put in the global folder. The next one I want to talk about is the SAS folder. I know Angular is keeping the CSS always on the component level of if you create a component, there's automatically a CSS file with it if you generate it. But I don't think that's a really good choice. I believe it's very it can combine much more. It gives you a lot more of tools if you keep it on an application level instead of a component level. It gives you much more choices if you want to inherit some CSS from, I don't know, from Bootstrap or from. It's very simple to do that on the application level. It's a little bit more hard to do that on the component level. So that's basically where the SAS folder does need for. I talked a little bit about that headless CMS project. So everything that I've going to talk about in this point is basically how you're going to create an Angular application, a big Angular application, the wrong way. You'll see in the next slides why that's the case, but we'll get there. So this is our headless CMS. Our customers use this headless CMS to basically for everything. So for content management, for shop module, for reviews, for users, for a whole lot more. It's like I said before, it's completely written in Angular. As you can believe, it's a lot of code for every little piece, every little tweak that you'll see in the next slides. So this is a next view of this headless CMS. Here, customers can write their own articles or products or cars. I don't know. It's completely templatable. So with our structure that we have before, I've added a little bit more files. So in the global, you'll see this has everything that's it's global for the whole application folder. And you will see that in that beheer mapje, there's the code for the management tool. But if I highlight these two folders, that's the really the manageable or the files that matter and that run the application. That's a better word. So this is the module TypeScript file. I've tried very hard to keep the file on one slide, but as you can see, it's the end is not visible. It's a very heavy file. It's got a lot of codes. We had this at one point in our journey of making this this headless CMS app, and as you can see, it's not the right way. This is our routes file. This every route that you'll have, there's a lot of routes that the user can go to. Also, you don't see the end. And more very important, if you build this project and in this current structure, you will see that this has a 3 megabytes of a main of our own code that it runs at runtime. This is massive, 3 megabytes. If I went to an Angular event, they always talk about, look how great this application is. It's also a little so small, but they never show the big applications how much code and how much the build size is of your project. So let's do this a little bit more better. We'll add lazy loading and the router module. As I said before, this is a thing that's I think a year or 2 years that it's already out. You can do lazy loading so long, I guess. But if we'll add this to our project, you will see this is the same two files that I showed before. You can see the module file and you can see the routes file. There you can see the end, by the way, on the one slide. It's a massive change if you go to the first structure and the second structure. So I think we're on the right track to improving our Angular application. Let's dive a little bit deeper of how lazy loading exactly works. So I put one chunk out. So the content module that you've seen in the slides. In our main routes file, you can see that this is the link to another routes file. So basically, you create all little small modules that will lazy load whenever you need them to lazy load. That's basically the idea. But on a code level, you can put code that only is needed for the content module to a different space in the project. I think as a developer, this is so much more maintainable. This is so I was so happy when I found out that this was the right way to use with our headless CMS app. This is a little bit more the better explanation of the lazy loading. As you can see, the green circles, I think you can see them as the content module. So in our first structure, it was attached to the main root. In our second structure, it was still attached, but in a chunk. You can split them from the main routes or the main app. If we go back to our structure, you will see that there is a folder that's added to the structure. It's our own naming convention, so you can call this folder whatever you want. But in our convention, it's called libs. So in libs, you have all these small modules that you can find there. And you have for each module an app module.ts and an app.routes.ts. Okay. And if we go back to the build from the project, you can see a lot more files than in the first approach. That's basically all the little chunks from all the different modules that you'll have. But much more important, if you'll see the change from 3 megabytes to 933 kilobytes, that's a massive change. I think that's the way that you'll want to make those big applications. A big notice that I want to add to this. If you think lazy loading, for every application in Angular, I want to add lazy loading. That's not the good choice, I think. It's only working the best at the larger applications. For instance, if you use this in a small application, and I did this test once, you'll see that the bundle will be much more bigger. It's basically logical that it's bigger because Angular adds some code to do the lazy loading, of course. That's not code that it's not included when you start a project from zero. The next point that I want to talk about is Angular elements. So all the other points were from the headless CMS. Angular Elements is another handy tool to make your application better. This is not used for the headless CMS, but it's we used it for example for this shop. So if you have an environment where you have a website that's run in PHP or in ASP.NET, and you'll want to create two widgets, in old terms, widgets for our product view and for a header mini to link with account, to link with shop, to link with I don't know. You can link it to so many things. This is really difficult to do in Angular because Angular doesn't allow to load so much times. It's intended to load once and only once. But there's a handy tool to create this, to do this kind of application, and that's basically web components. So web components is not an Angular thing. It's a thing that's basically you can do it in each framework, you can do it in React, you can do it in Vue. And what you have to do this with Angular, you can add a custom element to the app.module. So if you define this element, for instance, if we go back one slide, this header mini, if you define it in the app.module, you will load that component in another module. That's basically what it does. So that's pretty cool, I think. I think that's really good for timing, I guess. So that was very, very fast to that I went to the slides. But if you have questions, I would love for you to ask them. So shoot.